السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. سورة البقرة، سورة نمبر 2، verse 103. الله سبحانه وتعالى says: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولو أنهم آمنوا واتقوا لمثوبة من عند الله خير لو كانوا يعلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقولوا راعنا وقولوا انظرنا واسمعوا وللكافرين عذاب أليم. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم، والله يختص برحمته من يشاء، والله ذو الفضل العظيم. ما ننسخ من آية أو ننسها نأتي بخير منها أو مثلها، ألم تعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير؟ ألم تعلم أن الله له ملك السماوات والأرض، وما لكم من دون الله من ولي ولا نصير؟ أم تريدون أن تسألوا رسولكم كما سئل موسى من قبل؟ ومن يتبدل الكفر بالإيمان فقد ضل سواء السبيل. ود كثير من أهل الكتاب لو يردونكم من بعد إيمانكم كفارا حسدا من عند أنفسهم من بعد ما تبين لهم الحق، فاعفوا واصفحوا حتى يأتي الله بأمره، إن الله على كل شيء قدير. وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة، وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله، إن الله بما تعملون بصير. سورة البقرة، سورة نمبر 2، verse 103. الله سبحانه وتعالى says: ولو أنهم آمنوا واتقوا لمثوبة من عند الله خير لو كانوا يعلمون. Last week we were discussing about this ayah, the ayah number 102, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the shayateen who used to teach magic at the time of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam, and that people were very eager to learn the magic witchcraft from them. And they used to practice in their life, and through the effect of that magic or witchcraft, they used to separate husband and wife and put enmity between people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a test and as a trial, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent two angels to them to teach that witchcraft to them. But they always informed people before people were telling them to learn that magic from them. They told them not to learn it, but still people insisted, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about them that they are the people who have done worse in their worldly life, who have sold their own selves, and they did not know the consequences, the result of that practices which they did. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, in ayah number 103, mentions that if they had believed and they have guarded themselves from the evil, which they used to practice in their life, and they had kept their duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so it would have been far better in reward for them from their Lord, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is mentioned in ayah number 103. And then in ayah number 104, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about the manners of speech that when you address the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do not resemble or do not follow the disbelievers. When the disbelievers used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they used to draw his attention, saying they used to use this word ra'ina, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this ayah, but they used to twist their tongue, and their intention was to insult the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to mock at the religion of Allah, Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believers not to follow them or not to act like those disbelievers were doing. And Allah told them that instead of ra'ina, you say unzurna wasma'u. Also, then in ayah number 105, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about the enmity which they had in their hearts regarding the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they wish that he would have not been given the revelation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that this is a rahmah, this is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants this blessing to whomever he wills. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been chosen as a prophet from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the rahmah, because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah does not care what these disbelievers are willing or wishing for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then if you see ayah number 106, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the abrogation. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to reveal one verse and one hukm and one command in that verse, but due to some reasons or for the benefit, so that human beings could get more benefit, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to abrogate that verse with the complete recitation and the hukm, and sometimes with just the hukm, the command from that, and sometimes with the recitation, but the hukm remain in practice. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in ayah number 106. Especially Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds people that these disbelievers, they don't believe on this nasr, on this abrogation, and that they think that when Islam came, so Islam abrogates everything. Now people have to believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in the glorious Quran. Some people were not ready to accept that fact and they denied it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that Allah does not care what these people are saying or what they are thinking. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of everything. He knows and he is able to do everything, whatever he can do, whatever comes, it comes with his will and with his power. So they must know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most powerful, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls everything. The dominion of the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not have any wali or protector or any helper besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do everything. Regarding the abrogation, it is possible with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he can abrogate for the benefit of humanity, and he did it. So they believe or not, these disbelievers, they believe or do not believe, it does not matter or it does not bother Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then if you see ayah number 108, you know how Bani Israel used to ask questions after questions. They used to ask questions to their prophets, especially in Surah Al-Baqarah, you have been learning that how many questions they might have asked Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, but they did not believe. They asked for food, they were provided food that nobody was provided in the whole world. They were provided so much favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you cannot count them, you cannot imagine. Like this, some people came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they asked that, if you are a true prophet from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can you turn this Safa mountain to gold? Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them that yes, it is possible. But what if you even do not believe after it is turned to gold? If it becomes gold and you do not believe, so you would be like the Bani Israel when they asked Musa alayhi salatu wasalam different things. And Allah's Messenger Musa alayhi salatu wasalam requested Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed His blessings upon them, but still they turned to disbelief and they did not believe in Musa and in Allah's oneness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about this in this ayah, in ayah number 108, أَمْ تُرِيدُونَ أَن تَسْأَلُوا رَسُولَكُمْ كَمَا سُئِلَ مُوسَى مِنْ قَبْلِ. Do you want to ask your messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Musa was asked before? And then in ayah number 109, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about the intention of those people of scripture, those disbelievers, that they always wish that if the Muslims believers could turn away as disbelievers, they could turn away from belief and they could be disbelievers. And it was a hasad, it was an envy, a enmity in their hearts, and it was even the truth was clear in front of them. They had the Quran in front of them, but still because of their hatred, because of their enmity, they never wished that the disbelievers would be upon the true path. They always wish that the believers should turn away from the right path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then commands to perform the salawat and give charity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the benefit for spending in charity is that it is something which you are forwarding, which you are sending before you leave or you depart this worldly life. Whatever you send, whatever you spend in the way of Allah, it is reserved for you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will find it in a better reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in these ayahs. When we start the ayah, ayah number 103, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَمَثُوبَةٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ. You connect this ayah with the previous ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the witchcraft which was practiced at the time of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, how people practiced that magic in their life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that it would have been better for those people if they had believed in Allah and guarded themselves from the evil, and if they had kept their duty towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so it would have been better for them in reward from their Lord. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا. And if they had believed, وَاتَّقَوْا, and they guarded themselves from the evil and they kept their duty to Allah, لَمَثُوبَةٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٍ, then far better would have been the reward from their Lord. مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٍ, would have been far better the reward with their Lord, لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, if they but knew. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَقُولُوا رَاعِنَا وَقُولُوا انظُرْنَا وَاسْمَعُوا وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns them against their manner in speech that they used to say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ra'ina. Ra'ina in Arabic means be careful, listen to us, or we listen to you. This is the meaning of Ra'ina. But they used to twist their tongue to insult the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as in Hebrew, the word ra'ina means insult. So they used to twist their tongue and say to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ra'ina. Ra'ina, when they used to twist their tongue and they say ra'ina, that means shepherd, or our shepherd. Or another meaning of ra'ina is ahmaq, means stupid or fool, foolish. So then that is what they used to say to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned them and told them that they should not do it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also warned the believers to imitate them, because some of the believers, they also used to say the same things to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also in the Quran, there is another verse in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses this. And this is in Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 46, where it says, مِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَمَّ وَاضِعِهِ وَيَقُولُونَ سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا وَاسْمَعْ غَيْرَ مُسْمَعٍ وَرَاعِنَا لَيَّنْ بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ وَطَعْنًا فِي الدِّينِ ولو أنهم قالوا سمعنا وأطعنا واسمع وانظرنا لكان خيرا لهم وأقوم ولكن لعنهم الله بكفرهم فلا يؤمنون إلا قليلا. This ayah explains this ayah here where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the trick or their habit which they used to practice at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that among them there are some who displace words from their right places. مِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَمْ مَوَاضِعِ. They misplace the words from the right places. وَيَقُولُونَ, and they say, سَمِعْنَا, we hear your word, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then they say, وَعَصَيْنَا, and we disobey. So we hear and we disobey. وَاسْمَعْ غَيْرَ مُسْمَعْ, and hear and let you, O Muhammad, hear nothing. This is what they used to say. وَرَاعِنَا لَيَّمْ بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ وَطَعَانًا فِي الدِّينِ. And they used to say, رَاعِنَا, with a twist of their tongues, and وَطَعَانًا فِي الدِّينِ, and as a mockery of the religion of Islam. Allah says, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ, instead of these words, if they would have said these words, if would have been better if they only had said, we hear and obey. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, we hear and obey. وَاسْمَعْ وَانْظُرْنَا, and do make us understand. So لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ, it would have been better for them. And وَأَقْوَمْ, and more proper. But they will not do it, and they are not doing it, because لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِكُفْرِهِمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed them for their disbelief. So they believe not except a few. So few of them are those who believe, otherwise they do not believe. Also, if you see at the ayah here, ayah number 104, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us two things from this ayah. Number one is that we should not use such words in which you can see that there is a shaiba, or what you call an indication of mocking at religion or at the teachings of Islam. So you cannot use those words. Also, in your daily dealings and talking, and when you speak to one another, if you know some words that might harm or might hurt the other person's feelings, so you should avoid those words. Also, the other thing which Allah's message, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us, that you do not imitate the disbelievers. And also there's a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he said, مَن تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ, that if you follow, copy anybody or resemble somebody in qawl or amal, in words or in actions, that then this person will be regarded as from amongst them. So these are two important lessons which we learn from this ayah. Also, there is a report that a man from the tribe of Qaynuqa used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, And then he used to say to him, "Hear, غَيْرُ مُسْمَعٍ." He used to say this word to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That means, let you hear nothing. The Muslims used to think that the prophets are greeted and honored with this type of speech. And this is why some of them used to say, "Hear and let you hear nothing," and so on, as mentioned in Surah An-Nisa, يَمِنَ الَّذِينَ هَذُوا يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَمَّ وَضْعِهِ. Thereafter, Allah forbade the believers from uttering the word ra'ina. And instead of ra'ina, Allah commanded them to use the word unzurna. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, say not to the Messenger of Allah, ra'ina. Waqulu, and say unzurna. Unzurna, make us understand. Wasma'u, and hear. Walil kafirina adhabun alim. And for the disbelievers, there is a painful torment. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم والله يختص برحمته من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم. Here Allah explains about the enmity which the disbelievers had in their heart. Allah says that they will never wish anything good for our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they must learn it, but they must know it, that Allah is the owner of everything, and He rewards whomsoever He wills. مَا يَوَدُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Neither those who disbelieve among the people of the Scripture, وَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ, and nor المشركين, the idolaters and the disbelievers in the oneness of Allah, those pagans. أَنْ يُنَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Neither of those like that there should be sent down unto you any good from your Lord. أَنْ يُنَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ, that any goodness be revealed upon you. مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, from your Lord. But it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Lord of everything. وَاللَّهُ يَخْتَصُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. So Allah chooses for His mercy whom He wills. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ, and Allah is the owner of great bounty. When you see next verse number 106, مَا نَنْسَخْ مِنْ آيَةٍ أَوْ نُنْسِهَا نَأْتِ بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا أَوْ مِثْلِهَا أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed many books. The big books, which are called Kitab, and the small Sahifas, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent prophets and messengers so that they could implement the commands of Allah among people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end revealed this Quran. There will be no book after the glorious Quran. Quran is the final book. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger. There will be no prophet or messenger after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when the glorious Quran came, it was now everybody's responsibility or duty to follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which were revealed in the glorious Quran. And then in the glorious Quran, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala time to time revealed verses, but due to some benefits of more benefit of human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abrogated some verses, sometimes with the recitation and with the command, sometimes with the recitation alone, and sometimes with the hukm, with the command. But some of the Yahud, they did not believe in that, as they did not believe that now it is the Quran which everybody must follow, and Quran abrogates whatever came before the glorious Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in this ayah, مَا نَنْسَخْ مِنْ آيَةٍ أَوْ نُنْسِهَا نَأْتِ بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا أَوْ مِثْلِهَا. Whatever ours revelation do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, we bring a better one or similar to it? Know you not that Allah is able to do all things? And alam ta'lam anna Allah lahu mulku samawati wal ard wa ma lakum min dunillahi min waliyyin wala naseer? Know you not that it is Allah to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and besides Allah you have neither any wali, protector or guardian, nor any helper? When we look at the Mufassirin, they talk about these ayahs, and they have mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directed His servants to the fact that He alone is the owner of His creatures, and that He does with them as He wills. Indeed, His is the supreme authority, and all the creation is His, just as He created them as He wills. He brings happiness to whom He wills, mercy to whom He wills, health to whom He wills, and ailment to whom He wills. He also brings success to whom He wills and failure to whom He wills. He judges between His servants as He wills, allows what He wills and disallows what He wills. He decides what He wills. There is no opponent for His judgment, and no one can question Him about what He does. While they shall be questioned, He tests His servants and their obedience to His messenger by the nasq. Nasq means abrogation. He commands a matter containing a benefit which He knows of, and then out of His wisdom prohibits it. Hence, perfect obedience is realized by adhering or sticking to His command, following His messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, believing in whatever they convey, implementing their commands and avoiding what they prohibit. The statement of Allah here contain tremendous benefit, prove that the Yahud are disbelievers, and they refute their claim that nasq does not occur. In ignorance and arrogance, they claim that the sound mind stipulates that nasq does not occur. Some of them falsely claim that there are divine texts that dismiss the possibility that nasq occurred. So this is what they used to think. Imam Abu Ja'far ibn Jarir says that the ayah means, do you not know that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that I alone owe the heavens and the earth, and that I decide whatever I will in them. I forbid whatever I will, change and repeal whatever I will of my previous rulings whenever I will, and I also uphold whatever I will. Also he says, although Allah directed His statement indicating His greatness towards His Prophet, He also rejected the lies of the people who denied that the rulings of the Torah could undergo nasq, like abrogation. They denied the prophethood of Jesus and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of their dislike for what they brought from Allah, such as changing some rulings of the Torah as Allah commanded. Allah thus proclaimed to them that He owns the heavens and the earth, and also all the authority in them. Further, the subject in Allah's kingdom are His creation, and they are required to hear and obey His commands and prohibitions. Allah has full authority to command the creation as He wills, forbidding them from what He wills, and abrogate what He wills, uphold what He wills, and decide whatever commands and prohibitions Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. So this is what some of the Mufassirin have mentioned. Also Imam Ibn Kathir rahmatullahi alayh has mentioned that that their dismissal of occurrence of the abrogation is only a case of their disbelief and rebellion. The sound mind does not deny that there could be a nasq, means abrogation, in Allah's commandments, for He decides what He wills, just as He does what He wills. Further, abrogation occurred in previous books and law. For instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed to marry His daughters to His sons, and then later forbid this practice. Allah also allowed Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam to eat from all kinds of animals after they left the ark, then prohibited eating some types of foods. Further, marrying two sisters to one man was allowed for Israel and his children, but Allah prohibited this practice later in the Torah. Allah commanded Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to slaughter his son, then repealed that command before it was implemented. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the children of Israel to kill those who worship the calf and then repealed that command so that the children of Israel were not at all exterminated. There are many other instances, but they admit that they have occurred, yet they ignore them and they don't believe in them. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has talked about in these ayats. مَا نَنْسَخْ مِنْ آيَةٍ أَوْ نُنْسِهَا. Whatever a verse do we abrogate to cause to be, or we cause to be forgotten, أَوْ نُنْسِهَا. نَأْتِي بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا. Allah says, we bring a better one or similar to it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ. Know you not that Allah is able to do all things? أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. Know you not that it is Allah to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and besides Allah you have neither any wali, protector or a guardian, nor any helper. Inshallah, we'll continue from the next ayah, number 108. Jazakumullah khairan.